Mike Murphy, Marty.
Yeah.
Hey, I'm Mike Murphy.
I'm Mike Murphy, Marty.
Dempsey. The Dempsey fella.
Get your ass.
The Dempsey
here.
Fella.
How are you doing now?
Like myself, didn't you used to be on the telly?
Ah, oh, look at you. Hello there.
It'll bring you back when you see some of the stuff.
There he is.
Hi, you sweet thing. How are you now?
Maybe you used to your Charlie Hoey, which was so good on the live, Mike.
Where are you?
I'd forgotten half of Mike.
They were a great bit of gas.
Madam, would you care to enter our contest for a free mini today?
Yes.
Well, if I could ask you, madam,
just
to enter this contest by giving us the first two lines of Danny Boy in the key that we have here.
You don't mean I'm to sing it? I'll have a go.
All right, well, would you care to sing?
Now, here. In here.
Yes.
Danny boy, the pipes are calling.
From glen to glen, and o'er the mountain stream. But come ye back, when summer's
in the meadow. All right, all together.
I've got the words. This is desperate.
They're some of the oldest ones, the first ones we ever did. And of course, I haven't seen them since in 20, 30 years. So they're quite funny. When you look at them, they are quite funny. And they were pushing it a bit.
Good afternoon. I'm from the health board. I tell you what, there's been an outbreak of morphitis in this area. And I'm just checking on people. Do you mind if I take your pulse, please? Just hold on a second. You don't get pains at night or anything like that, do you? Do you get any pains?
My stomach.
Your stomach?
Yeah.
Do you? At night?
No, in the morning.
You'll be all right now in the morning when you wake up?
No, only in the morning I wake up.
All right. Just hold on a second. So don't open your mouth. Say, Just step out there on the map and just... Right, say 95.
You really like the people you're winding up, so, and that's always what we wanted to do with Naked Camera as well. Like, if you ask anyone on the Naked Camera crew who what we're doing and who we look up to and who we want to make, it's always, we always say, every time we do a reveal, we always say, do you remember Mike Murphy? It's never, you know, Punked or Candid Camera or Borat. It's always, do you remember Mike Murphy? Because we love it, like.
They were kind of pushing the envelope a bit for their time, and that was why people enjoyed them. And, of course, the audience were in on it. They knew it's Mike Murphy. The other people didn't, and that was the joke.
Do you know the Alleluia chorus?
I do.
Well, I'll tell you, I'll start it off, if you like.
Ah, Father.
Do you know the one?
I do.
Well, now, if I start it off, so we can all join in.
Good actor, great natural comedian, great for extemporising and inventing on the moment, and you can see that there.
I do a lot of social work in my own life, and I have no interest.
I see. I don't suppose you have a drink in the house at all.
I can give you, I have some cola. Would that be all right?
No, I'll tell you what, sometimes, you know, you get the craving and that you like a little drink of something, and the Coke, I don't like that very much at all. I don't suppose you have anything stronger at all,
no,
do you?
No.
I see. Well, I tell you, we'll all join in a quick chorus now. The Adistin.
I don't have any of these at home, so this is the first time, genuinely, I've seen these since we actually filmed them, you know. It's extraordinary to look back at what we got away with, isn't it?
Gradually, I realised I had teeth and I was able to kind of push it a little bit. And I think the first one with teeth, the first hard-edged one, which got an amazing reaction all around the country, was the one with the late Paddy Martin, the butcher in Dundalk.
Hello, I'm from Martin's.
Sorry?
I'm from Martin's to do the signs.
For who?
I have another one here.
For who?
Should I have another one here to finish off?
If you don't get away from that window quick, I'll get the guard and get you.
Sure, I won't look at this only STR there.
You team, don't put anything more in that window. Get to the verge of here quick before I get you arrested.
That was what tickled people, because that was the first one on a home-produced programme where the real life thing happened and somebody did get aggressive and upset. And he was upset. Now, he took it really well afterwards and actually became quite famous as a result of it. But that was the first one that had a bit of edge.
Who's going to finish the winter for you?
I'll finish it myself.
Are you sure?
Yes, I'll finish.
Are you sure,
yeah.
Now? Well, listen.
Yes. Right. You take that out and run. Look at back, you'll be any more.
Do you not want me to finish the window?
I don't really want to. You've got to be way, for God's sake.
Once Mike got them raised that much, he'd keep sticking the finger in, hoping... against hope that somebody would swing at him, because that would have been great.
Do you not want me to finish it? Hello? Mr. Martin? I'll tell you what. My name is Mike Murphy from Television Ireland.
I know.
Norman. See the camera there? Look.
I know, but that's not
I realised, and so did everybody else, that there was a capacity in this for doing other things.
Welcome back.
I was in the live mic from the beginning. Yeah, I was in it from the word go. But my role in the live mic extended as the show went on.
Mr. Haughey will not be appearing in this programme either.
They would have always regarded myself as a scripted actor. I was an actor. And here, all of a sudden, you had no script.
Dermot Morgan, as we know from God Be Good to Him, from Father Ted, was a unique talent.
We are sailing. And what are we sailing? Across the sea. The sea of life.
So we said, OK, that's a good team. Let's see how it works. And it all just clicked. And you can see that the bicycle shop, that was Paddy Walsh, God rest him. And I knew him from the time I was a kid, but of course he didn't cop it. And it was quite funny how he changed. Oh, Jesus, Mike, how are you? He was so nice about the whole thing.
Hello, Thomas Berry, that's a very nice bicycle,
yeah,
this
but
one.
It's not for sale.
Oh, is it not?
No, there's no damper sale.
There's no damper sale,
no,
is
no,
it not?
No, it's in for repairs.
But now it's. I'll tell you, it's a thing. I never have been riding a bicycle before, you know. Doctor, can I try it? Just
no,
around.
No, no, no. You have to get off it.
I'll have a try.
No,
just
no,
around.
No,
it. And then I'll just say
no,
it. But
no,
like,
no,
I
won't
no,
have
no.
a try.
I could say it then.
No,
oh,
no.
I might like to buy it.
You're not
you
selling
it.
It's not for sale.
But if I tried it around the block once,
no.
I might decide that I might
you're
like to buy a bicycle.
You
know what I mean? Do you know what I mean?
I know what you mean, but the grass is wet.
No, the grass is wet?
Yeah, come on.
Well, I'll tell you.
You guys took a bike here before on me. I never got it back.
What?
You took a bike here before on me.
Me?
Yeah.
Oh, I never did. It must have been
get
someone
in,
else. I'll try one of them motorbikes. They're very nice.
I'll get the guards down out of
what? You see, I never ride in a bicycle before, you know. It's not a man. I'll just try this
you're
one.
Not trying nothing!
What?
Not
that,
what? Not that I said. That.
They're very
right
nice.
Now.
Right on.
Come on.
Will I go?
You better
go.
Go. Come on. Before the guards come down.
My name is Mike Murphy from RTE.
Oh, Jesus, Mike. How are you?
And in fact, immediately after that, we were out for the day doing that. And I said, my father had a garage just down the road. And I said, God, you know what we'll do? We'll go down and try and catch my father and see if I'd catch him out. And we did. And we went and I did catch him out. It was amazing.
Can I have a go at this? I'd like to have a spin at that, you know? Huh?
Mike is out, he has the keys.
Mike has the keys up it?
Yeah.
Can I drive something around the block?
What's the point?
I'd like to have a drive with something, you know?
What's the point?
Because I might buy it, you know? If I was interested, I might take it, you know what I mean?
Well, you'd have to come back in an hour.
Well, I'll have a go at something now. Give us a key to bring some of your car down and have a go.
No, I know I won't. You take it off.
I'll take this one here.
The Bedford van.
What?
I wouldn't take it in the Bedford van.
Well, I tell you, you don't have to take the van, but I might buy something like you anyway, right?
How much? What sort of money you be talking to?
I'm talking in terms now of 40, 50.
40, 50 what?
40, 50 quid. I'll go as far as 60.
I'm sure we're looking at 2,500.
2,500 for that? Are you joking me or something?
No.
40 or 50 quid as much as it?
76.
Oh, that's 40 or 50 quid I'll give you, bro. Cash?
No.
There'll be no questions asked, wouldn't you, no? Would
you like to... You're wasting your time.
Would you like to come for a drink?
No, thanks.
Are you sure?
Positive.
With a little flask in the wagon, would you like a little drop? Are you sure now?
Positive.
Huh?
Positive.
Do you often appear on the television, do you?
Never.
Do you not,
Dad? Never.
Come here. Gotcha.
He was doing it before. Anyone was doing it, and that's the thing, isn't it? That's like, I suppose, I don't know, what does go through your head? You're just laughing. It's the same. The good thing is it's the same reaction from people then as you still get from people now. Like, you just confuse an Irish bloke, and if he has a cigarette, he'll go, you know, that sort of thing. So I suppose, yeah, I don't know. What does go through my head? Nothing goes through my head normally. But it's funny. That's all that matters. It's funny for funny's sake. And that's brilliant.
I'm from the Department of Health.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I want you to buy it.
To see that?
No, I won't buy it.
Why do I salt you? See them marks there?
Yeah, not buying it.
Do you know what that is?
Fine.
That's the marks of the black widow spider. You see, there's a thing in the middle. See that thing in the middle?
Yes, 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 yes.
That's the Nicaraguan tape worm.
Well, thanks for telling us.
With all of these, I was a kind of a grotty kind of a character, and always sent by a higher authority to do something, to put muck on your windscreen, to write on your window, to start putting glitter on your house, sent by somebody else, and I had to do it. Like, I have to, you know, that's me job, right?
You see?
Well, listen, I tell you, love, you're not to be eating the stuff.
You see, Mr. Howard said I was to come out.
Hey, right, come on, away.
You see, I'm from the department.
I don't care where you're from.
You're very nice. You're
waiting
there.
You see, unfortunately, the thing is,
now, don't come around here or else I'll keep you kicking the arteries in there.
You see, unfortunately, these carrots come in. I know, yes, I understand the feelings of Errol. I just, you see, I have to take a bite out of all of these things so that the people who's coming along...
Yeah. Yeah. The answer.
You see, what the people who's coming along know that the things have got the black widow spider.
Like, I just remember sitting there as a young fella and pissing myself laughing. And even if I didn't get it, I was pissing myself laughing, looking at me folks, pissing themselves laughing, just because, you know, it's that thing. Irish people love a wind-up.
Excuse me. Come here a second. Look.
What?
My name is Mike Murphy.
I don't know.
I've got the camera over there, and you're on at the moment.
Joking lost.
In those days, there was not as much competition. You didn't have all the hundreds of channels in Sky and so on. So people were very loyal to the home station, and there were stars made in a way that maybe they can't be made now, because everybody watched Mike Murphy.
We used to go around with an old bread van, O'Brien's bread, with the hole cut in the O and the camera stuck out the side of that. And of course it meant we could never go into anybody's house. We could only park the van outside, and the camera had to shoot with me at the door. So I'd nearly have a wobbly if they say, come inside. And I say, no, I can't come inside, because that'd be the end of the whole thing.
Hello, I'm here about the washing.
What?
I'm here about the washing. The washing. I tell you, I'm in a bit of a rush, do you know? Hello, yeah. That's a nice little fella. Ronnie, I'm in a bit of a rush, so if I could leave them now, I'll be back around 6 o'clock to collect them. I'll be back around the 6 o'clock mark, because I tell you, I am in a bit of a rush, you know, and I can't be hanging around here talking all day. So if you'll take them now, you needn't iron them now, and I'll be back in a few minutes.
What's supposed to do?
Wash them.
Must be a joke.
I'll be back in a few. Well, I tell you now, I tell you, I'm in a bit of a rush. I'd love to stay around talking to you, but I tell you, I have to go off now and do a bit of walk. But I'll be back around 6, if you can have them for me then. Now, no ironing on them.
There were times when we were going around and we just couldn't think of anything to do. And I think that washing was one of those. And it was kind of, what? We have the camera, we're out for the day, we have to get something. And I think it was as desperate as that. So it was desperation rather than inspiration.
Could I leave a few bits with you?
Sorry,
I've only got a few. If I leave them with you, would that be all right? Here, will you take them?
You just took the wrong purse.
No, it's about the washing. If I could leave them with you, just, I'll be back about 6. Will I leave them here?
Yeah, all right.
Right, I'll leave them there. Well, no, thanks very much. I'll be back about 6 o'clock for the rest of the washing.
But they took the washing. That was the amazing thing, how people reacted if you approached them in a certain way.
And that was in Ireland then, maybe, where people were more innocent or more friendly. But I suppose Mike was very... charming and very persuasive.
What time of day does the common market open?
Oh,
you've only 2 seconds left. What time?
God, what time does the EC open at?
Yeah, that's right.
What time of day does the common market open?
You mean here in Europe?
I might bleep you now. I'll give you this one more time now.
What time do you expect the common market to close?
Same time as ourselves. That's very good. I give you that. You just before the butter went.
You would find people would take you seriously. So, yeah, you were asking people's reactions in a funny kind of a way.
Now, tell us this, the capital of France. What's the capital of France?
I don't know and I don't care.
Do you know the capital of France?
No.
Could they tell us what EU country spaghetti was grown in?
Yes. Where does spaghetti grow? Where does spaghetti grow? I don't think now. Hold on. Sorry, no. You didn't get that right.
Would you be able to tell me when is spaghetti harvested? Do you know when they harvest the spaghetti?
Spaghetti?
Yeah, the spaghetti. Oh. The loud, stringy stuff.
Yes, I know the stuff you mean.
Yeah. And they went into great rounds of thinking where the spaghetti was grown. And with deadpan faces about growing the spaghetti, like presumably breaking the lengths of it, putting it in the packages and sending it to the supermarkets.
You don't know.
No, we can't give you that either. Now, when you're eating frog's legs, do you start from the ankle and work your way up, or do you start from the top and work your way there?
But as long as you made it look official and you had a clipboard, that was the main thing, and you were earnest. And persistent. You never wanted to get into rude. Persistent was sufficient.
What would you use a gigolo for?
Man who's funny,
you know. Is that right? Yeah. A man who's funny. I hope.
Now, in a way, the reveal is almost a merciful release to them because you can see their suffering and there's an element of you thinks, oh, I shouldn't be doing this to people.
Well, tell us this now. Have you been on the telly before?
Never.
Have you not? No. Well, you're being on it at the moment.
Oh, God, no! Oh, you're trying to see me. And look at me. Oh, no.
My name is Mike Murphy from RTE. Oh,
Jesus.
Oh, shit. No, that's not all. I don't think we can accept
that. The way we work is changing, but 8 decades of fascinating archive footage reveals that the world of work reshapes itself with each new generation.
People didn't change jobs.
The Way We Were continues with How We Worked tonight at 9:30 on RTE1 and RTE Player.
It's colourless, it's odourless, it's hard to detect. So carbon monoxide deserves your respect. It can kill you, stone dead, in just 3 minutes flat. And if you don't believe me, ask me dear Uncle Pash. Thank you. Coal, tar, oil, gas, even wood, any fuel can harm. So get yourself a carbon monoxide alarm, or you might just wake up dead.
Nobody likes arriving home to a chilly house. Make sure you're always cozy when you smarten up your home with Bord Gáis Energy. You can control your heating remotely with a free Hive Active heating control and make it voice activated with a free Amazon Echo Dot. The two combined mean you can smarten your home and help make it more energy efficient. This bundle offer also comes with 25% off electricity and 25% off gas. To switch to a smarter home, search Bord Gáis Energy Bundle.
Many businesses rely on goods moving to, from and through the UK, excluding Northern Ireland. Since the 1st of January, new permanent customs and regulatory checks are now in place due to the UK leaving the EU. This affects all businesses, big and small. Act now to avoid disruption and keep your goods moving. Get support and advice on Brexit at gov.ie/Brexit.
We are born. The sides are level and the game begins. Fear is a tough opponent. It can take an early lead. Courage is more unpredictable. It takes courage to play the game of your life.
Oh my gosh! Oh
And only you can decide the final result. Allianz, we cover courage.
Curiosity is everywhere. Follow yours wherever it might take you. With Vodafone's super fast gigabit broadband now available to more people than ever before.
I like Murphy Marty.
You're not like Murphy.
There's the one with the coffin outside St. Bartholomew's, where I now sing.
The coffin, oh God, I remember the coffin.
I'll bring it in a minute. In a moment.
It weaned you, didn't it?
It certainly did.
Into television.
And out again.
And out again.
Want to meet me, Hash? To have you is Shauna Kelly. Is she Sean English? It's not a very good.
Sorry, will you hold on a sec?
Could you tell me about it basically? Have you?
I think I'm Sean Kelly.
Did you see, it's funny, yeah.
Okay, you seem to be winning all over the world.
Particularly to be caught out by a like you. You know, smooth talking like you.
I was only copying you.
I know.
It's very nice to meet you, Sean. I'm very pleased.
Pleased to meet you.
Very, very pleased to meet you. Thank you very much. You say goodbye to the people in Iceland.
Good luck to the people.
Goodbye.
We were doing it on the basis we have a camera crew today. We won't have them tomorrow. We have to think of something to do, or as many as we can do, and in places as close to each other as we possibly can, so that we're stockpiling a few. It was just on the hoof.
Is the electric going underneath there?
Yeah, it comes all the way down there.
Does it? Whereabouts? Put your tell the show us right here, will you?
Well, it runs in a straight line more or less all the way down.
Does it?
Yeah.
All right, Mr. McLaughlin says it's all right, go ahead.
I reckon then nobody in Ireland would have thought that this was going to happen. Like, and definitely not happen to them at that time. Like, his best disguise ever. He's like Clark Kent. Just puts in a pair of false teeth. And there's this disguise, and people go, looks awful like Mike Murphy, but it couldn't be him.
Well, I don't know.
Will I take the pump out first? That pump is set. That's a pump set. Just the middle one.
We can do it with this. I can
Dermot and myself did the one. It was down in Black Rock, down in Booterstone somewhere. And I remember it was very, very funny because there was a young man minding the place for while the guy who did the petrol was off. And he was having... I mean, the poor guy didn't know how to handle it.
Yeah, what the...
I know, how was it? if you break it up, I know, that wouldn't be any use to him anyhow, that sort of pump. Yeah, but they put them into somewhere else.
You come on back there, we walk away, right?
I know, don't start it till I get your man up.
We don't need him.
He
doesn't need to be here, you know? As long as we get the authorization of a person on the premises, we're all right.
Well, I don't work here anymore. I used to work here, you see?
I know what you mean, but it doesn't matter. You see, that's all, as long as we have your name and address, we have authorization. Don't you know what I mean?
Right,
we can walk away there. Give
me a hand over
there.
Would you just put the end of the pick under it? We give it a tug between us. We give it a hand up between us.
Here, I'll hold that.
Get the end of
Tanner.
Right.
Just to pull, just to close it up.
Yeah.
Just to leave it up. Is
that
it heavy?
Is on the way out.
I know that.
You know, gas needs to be put in.
Yeah, well, you can't put the gas in until the gaffer gets here.
No, we don't need the gaffer to be here because you are here as the man on the premises.
Yeah, but even though I'm the man on the premises, I don't work here.
Well, that is, you see, according,
I used to work here.
According to the law, William, you don't need to be. Do you know what I mean?
Yeah.
As long as you are the person.
Wait.
He was gone.
You see, do you know what I mean? Like, there's your drink.
And for me, one of the funniest images of all, out of all the years, was when I had the sledgehammer and I was lifting it to knock the pump down, and he positioned himself against the pump and said, "You can't do it, you can't do it." It was kind of kill me, but don't knock the pump down. And I just thought, that's surreal.
I'm happy enough, you know, once you get the authorization from the person on the site, in situ, you're all right. You know, this is legal jargon.
It may be legal, but when your man comes back and says, you put bleeding gas in and we want the petrol, you know?
No, I think he'd be very pleased, actually.
He
you
be
see,
very pleased.
This garage has been selected. Thanks very much, William.
Wait. Now, your man will be back. He'll be back in a couple of minutes.
It doesn't lift.
Don't.
Well,
it's not.
Wait. Hang on.
No way.
See, he'd give the odd cheeky look to the crew. That's what we used to love.
Are you sure?
He'd just give that odd kind of little eye to you, like, this is going well, isn't it?
If you knock that down, I mean.
All right.
You know.
Well, I'll tell you, William, do you enjoy the television?
The television?
I'm Mike Murphy from RTE.
You know.
I am. There's the camera over there.
People, I think, believed that there was no telly Mike and off telly Mike, that there was one and the same sort of fella. And I think the people were really warm to that. So when he was off winding people up, you kind of got the feeling if the cameras weren't there, he'd be doing it anyway.
It was never really acting. You kind of got into a mode whereby I used to kind of, I'd be watching the other person very closely, and I'd be kind of seeing how far could I go, or what way could I bring this, where could I take this, and how much would I be able to get away with this. And that's, I was winging that all the time.
Can we watch the rest of them?
Hey, turn out porn. Fun nerd fee funny pa. Antuna, cut, took what? Nerd, but who left? Una, how is Funjit didn't approve what? Phoenix pa. Murder him, son, Vituna Taylor Fair. And time?
Guys, I know.
Tuna where?
Only Higgin.
Buna who to ask me to say?
Duke, Edward.
You come from Finland?
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, we do. We're very fond of Finland, in fact. Yeah. We like the Finland.
A tuna pan. A tuna tuna pan.
Yeah. So, what can I do? You said, are you from Finland?
Tuna pan, Finn.
Father, do you know anything about this language? You know this language, Father?
Mike is a great character actor. He always was. And he's also so composed where he can just remain very still.
What is gelding?
Oh, that's, yes, cut horse. Cut horse, if you like to put it. A gelding, yes, in other words, yes. It's a stallion who has been, who is not a stallion.
Not a gelding.
He's a cut horse.
You speak slowly?
Not a full horse.
It's not a mare. Not a, an entire. He's castrated.
Ah, no, he is woman horse.
No. I am not so.
The Bannockburn of tuna.
I wish I knew what you were talking about.
Thank you.
Very sorry, I might put on
you. No. No, you were very good, really, honestly.
Now, you can't.
My name is Mike Murphy from RTE.
Oh, you're not Mike Murphy.
We had no life while that series was on. I couldn't go in to do grocery shopping. I couldn't go into a shop to buy clothes. People would come and say, out, get out the door, you.
What kind of car is this?
A Nissan
Datsun. Datsun, Japanese model. I didn't know they took diesel.
No, that's not diesel. I don't want that. I don't want diesel.
But this is diesel.
Well, that was one of the ones where I followed Mike. Mike had done one of those, and I just thought it was such a classic idea. And the brown coat, and pretended to be the idiot on the forecourt.
A metro diesel.
No, it's not. You're not putting diesel into it, are you?
This is the diesel pump.
Oh, Jesus, don't put diesel in it. Right. No, stop, diesel. Please don't. Stop.
Well, I didn't. I put £4 in fourpence for it.
Well, stop. Take it out immediately. It's not diesel. It's petrol.
Well, I thought, why did you put up the diesel pump?
I didn't know it was the diesel pump.
Well, maybe if I put petrol in on top of the diesel.
Take everything that's in it out.
Yeah, but if I put more petrol in on top of it, might I lose it?
What do I have to do?
Well, if you leave the car at the lunch stamp, I get some of the lads, and we can turn on its side and empty it.
Are you sure that's diesel?
This is diesel, yeah. I'll tell you what, will you hold up for a second? Now, if you start sucking when I tell you.
And another gentleman that's shown sat beside me in school for 5 years, and he didn't recognise me at the time.
Get the diesel out of it and get it out of it now.
And he kept disappearing behind a pillar, so I had to keep pulling him by the elbow to get him in shot.
I thought you were going to give me a dick.
Oh, Jesus, Fran, you didn't.
Yes, I did.
He was laughing for 20 minutes afterwards, yeah.
Irish people love a wind-up. And anytime you see someone getting a wind-up, it's just, ha, 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 caught you, you sap. I think that's probably why it's better to wind-up Irish people than wind-up people anywhere else in the world. Like,
see the camera.
It's like half angry, but half knowing that if they had a half a chance, they'd do it to you as well.
Amazing what people will do, isn't it? Mm. If they see it's a figure of authority.
Yeah. Absolutely.
Or else someone persistent enough. Somebody persistent enough, you know, they will, just to get rid of you. So they'll do what you want.
Here's the gardens.
The garden center,
yeah. Oh, Lord, and I usually buy that when I need it, and I thought it was imported. I didn't think it could go in or...
Well,